Next, if you have read the topic, it says modals. Can anyone recall what are modals? We have done this in class 5 also. What are modals? Shifa?
Ma'am, modals are kind of auxiliary verbs. They help to tell us the meaning of main verb.
Excellent. Modals are kind of, you know, they are auxiliary verbs. They are just telling the, you know, they're working to help for the main verbs, that what is it, the possibility, the ability. If you remember, we have done can, could, shall, will, may. We have this separate chapters in class 5. This time we have this combined chapter, which is modal. In this we have can, could, shall, should, will, may, must. If you recall, these are the rules. Must is used where this is a necessity. You have to do it. Fine. Like this, we have this time also, we have our modals. This is again a recapitulation if you remember what we did in class 5. Fine. See, modals, we know these are the, you know, auxiliary verbs. They are just increasing the meaning of our main verbs. They show, see, is, am, are, was, were, they show the time, right? They show the time, present, past, or future, will. But here, this modals gives us the possibility, ability, you know, necessity, your habit. These are telling you the permission. May I come in? When you are at the door, you take the permission. Ma'am, may I come in? May I bring the water? This is more polite way of asking. Ma'am, can I send my work at 7 p.m.? You all ask me these questions online. So these, you already are using these modals in your day-to-day, you know, conversations. But we just have to realize their usages. Fine. Can is a present tense and could is a past tense. Could you please... Yes. If I say, I could do this, but the time has went. I could have done my work, but I forgot. Okay, this is your ability. This is showing your ability. Fine. See, this is modals are giving. If you can see my screen, modals are given here. Like can, could, may. May is a, I told you, more polite and formal way of asking for permission. Then again, present and future possibilities, offer help. May I carry this for you? May I give you my pen? Okay. Yes, you may or you may not, positive and negative of the permissions. Can, could, may, we have already done. Then with might. Might is a lesser, you know, when there is a lesser possibility. Like if I say, your school might open tomorrow. There is a possibility, but it is very less. It is not true. Your schools are not opening right now. Okay? To indicate, if you can see, to indicate what is less likely to happen. Must is compulsory. You must give me your work. You must attend the class. You must give the exam. You must study. This is your necessity. This is a compulsion. Okay. Then second usage in inference. Inference means when you come to a conclusion. Like, we have done this chapter, you must be aware of this. This is an inference. Ki hum kar chuke hain, to ye tumhe aana hi chahiye. This is a conclusion. Fine. If you have doubts, please raise your hand side by side. I'm going in a speed because this we already have done. I'm not going into detail because this is just a recapitulation of what we have already done. Yes, Shifa?
Ma'am, I have a doubt that, ma'am, what is inference?
Inference means when you are coming to that conclusion, to the final decision. Like I say, Arkan, I'm giving an example. Arkan and Shifa must be siblings because their face match. Fine? If I say you must you must know the answer because we have discussed it in the previous class. This is an inference. I have come to this decision, this conclusion, because we have done this. Inference means coming to the conclusion. Any other? Okay. Next, we have shall. See, shall is used with generally I. Used with the first person, I shall or we shall with the possibility. Then, when we indicate an order or when we suggest something in question, like shall we continue this in the next class? When I'm asking you, I'm giving a suggestion and asking a question. Both the things are going simultaneously. Right? Shall we wait for others? I'm asking the question, shall we wait? No, ma'am, we should not. We should start the class. Fine? Then your should, will is again future, when you are requesting again to show the possibilities. Would you do this for me to make an offer? Or when you are describing a habitual action in the past. Would is for again past, when something that is habitual, like Shifa would send the answers on time. That was in past, now she is being late. She is being lazy. This is not the case. I'm just giving the example because Shiva is coming on the top of my screen with her face visible. Others, your cameras are switched off. Fine. Any doubt, anyone, please switch on your cameras. Why the cameras are switched off? If there is a lot of network issue, then you can switch it off. But otherwise, come on, switch it on. Let's see each other. It's a good day. Make the class interesting. We interact with each other. Yes, Tavishi?
Ma'am, can you explain again shall, ma'am, because your voice was cutting in between.
Which is shall we use with I or we, firstly, for the first person. And then when we have to show, when we doing something that is for sure. Like, I shall give you marks for what you have done. Fine, this is a strong order, a strong resolution that I have taken. Or when we are suggesting and asking a question. Shall we complete the chapter today? I'm suggesting also that we should do this, and then I'm asking a question also that shall we do this? But only with I and we can use shall, not with the third or second person. Let's do question number A. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Filling the blanks with will or shall only. I dash get some rest before I start practicing for the show. Lakshay?
Ma'am, shall.
Excellent. You dash enjoy watching this film. It has a very unusual twist at the end. Mehak?
Ma'am, will.
Very good. Dash, I help you find a taxi. See, if you read the sentences also now, you will get the meaning. Shweta?
Ma'am, shall I?
Very good. He dash pay the price for his carelessness. Priyanshi?
Ma'am, he will pay the price for his carelessness.
He will pay the price for his carelessness. Bache, please remember, shall is only used with the first person, we or I. Vimal and his family are on their way to Chennai. They dash arrive at 6 o'clock. Ujwal?
Will.
Excellent. Dash, you wait until he's back. Shruti?
Ma'am, shall.
No, Bache. Will you wait? I turn off the computer. Geet.
Shell.
Very good. Any doubt here? Anyone? See, we have discussed shall use with first person to show the strong possibility. Fine. And will, we already know strong possibility, intention or request. Okay. Now there is a use. You have to put must wherever you think there should be, and you have to tell whether this is a necessity or an inference. That is a nasty wound. It must be very painful. So this is a inference. Fine. We plan to reach Delhi by 8 a.m. since the meeting is at 10. Where do you think must will come? Lakshya inference means a conclusion. Inference means when you're concluding this thing, that it is a nasty wound. It must be painful. You must have this pain. Okay, Shifa.
Ma'am, we must reach Delhi by 8 p.m. since the meeting is at 10.
Excellent. We must reach Delhi by 8 a.m. And what is this? Necessity or inference?
Necessity.
Very good. This is necessity. So we will write N here. Fine. I'm just putting the arrows. That means you have to write must here. Please do not forget to write must here. I'm not putting must again and again. Sorry. Fine. Geet, you have to put must wherever this is necessary, and you have to tell its usage, whether it is necessity or you are coming to a conclusion by reading the given lines. We fetch the doctor now. We fetch the doctor now if we are to save the dog. I don't know whether you know. Okay, now raise your hands. Lavina.
Ma'am, we must fetch the doctor now if we are to save the dog.
And what is this?
Ma'am, necessary.
Necessity. Very good. This is a necessity because if we have to save the dog, we must fetch the doctor. The sky is overcast. It be raining somewhere in the city. Lakshay?
Ma'am, the sky is overcast. It must be raining somewhere in the city.
Excellent. And what is this?
Ma'am, inference.
Inference. Excellent. Inference. Did the director say that we attend this seminar? Roshan?
Yes, ma'am.
Answer, bachche.
Ma'am, did the doctor say that we attend this seminar?
Where is must?
मुझे पता है मैम
मैम डिड द डॉक्टर से दैट वी मस्ट अटेंड दिस सेमिनार
एक्सीलेंट वी मस्ट एंड व्हाट इज दिस
मैम नेसेसिटी
नो व्हाई इट इज नेसेसिटी दिस इज इन्फेरेंस यू आर आस्किंग वी इनवाइट तारा एंड तरुण टू प्ले दे ऑलवेज आस्क अस टू जॉइन देम Please lower your hand, those who have gotten a chance for this question, so that I can give to others. Lavina?
Yes, ma'am.
You have gotten a chance for this question?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Mehak?
Yes, ma'am.
Answer, bachche.
Ma'am, we must invite Tara and Tarun to play. They always ask us to join them.
And ma'am, what is this?
Ma'am, necessity.
This is a necessity because they are doing, so we are doing. They already know the news. They have seen it on the TV. Shruti?
They already know the news. They must have seen it on TV.
And what is this?
Necessity.
This is inference. She have known it was your birthday. I didn't tell her. Pranjal?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Pranjal?
Ma'am, she must have known it was your birthday. I didn't tell her.
And what is this? Inference. Fine. Any doubt in this question, anyone? All right, let's move to question number 3. You have to use can or could by rearranging the words and add. Sorry, you have to add can or could by rearranging these words. Fine, let's start. Who will give the answer? Tavishi?
Yes, ma'am.
Jitha,
can I answer?
Yes, yes.
Can I speak to Mayuri, please? Then question
can
mark.
Can I speak to Mayuri, comma, please? Like this. Can I speak to Mayuri, please? Instead of comma also we can do it. Can I speak to Mayuri, please? Organize a function. We celebrate this victory too. Lavish?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Answer?
Do not know.
Okay. Lakshay?
We must organize a function to celebrate the victory.
Only can or could do?
We could celebrate a we could organize a function to celebrate this victory.
We could organize. Yes, you can do this past also. We could organize a function to celebrate this victory. Fine. Paint very well she portrays. Nikunj?
She could paint very well. She could paint very well.
Why could she can paint very well portraits?
She can.
This is her ability. Fifth one, Lavina.
Ma'am, can I help with your lessons after school?
Very good. Tavish has given. Those who have given this answer for this question, please lower your hands. Navya?
can you please, can you pass me those books, please?
Could you please pass me those books? Could you please pass me those books? Shifa?
Ma'am, I don't know the answer of this one.
Okay, anyone who knows this? Are not feeling well, go home. You, if you early well.
Ma'am, can I?
Yes, ma'am.
Can?
Yes. Yes, ma'am. Lakshay?
You can go home early if you are not feeling... you can go home early if you are not feeling very well.
Very good. You can go home early if you are not feeling well. Or, yes, this is the correct one. You can. We to find this subject, check the internet on more information. All right, I'll do this. You can check the internet to find more information on this subject. Fine. Any doubt in this? Anyone? Fine. Would and used to. See, these are the two words, two phrases that we generally use. Okay, would is used to talk about some action that are repeatedly done in the past and no longer happening. Like, I told you, Shifa would give the work on time. This was repeated in action but not happening now. This is just an example. And when we are using used to is in the same way, but for general truths. Like, we used to talk to each other. We used to be friends. Okay? They used to be farmers. We use used to when we are doing the regular activities and the habit activities. This is not habits. And when we are talking about general truths. But there are some phrases which we can use both. We used to go to the swimmings on Saturday. We would go to the swimmings on Saturday. When the things are repeatedly in the past. Fine, we have D, E, and F. Okay, let's do. You have to rewrite using used to only. You do not have to rewrite with would. Only use with used to. Fine. Let's do this. He would give me pocket money. What will you change? Shifa?
Ma'am, he used to give me pocket money.
Very good. He used to give me pocket money. Next, the pigeons came by each morning looking for food. Please remember, after used to, you have to use the simple tense, simple verb. Lavina?
Ma'am, the pigeons used to come by each morning looking for food.
Very good. The pigeon used to come by each morning looking for food. Fine. Any doubt in this? Can we do fourth, fifth, and sixth yourself? Seventh, eighth? Just change it into used to. Like the doctor used to call to see my father. We used to live. Just remember when we are using past tense, you have to, when we are using used to, you have to change the given word like lived into simple present like live. I used to work. When she was younger, she used to enjoy. Fine. Let's see E part. E part, you have to change, rewrite using would. Every weekend, I would go tracking with my friends. Sarah used to help me out with my studies. Lakshay, what will be the sentence?
Sarah would used to help me.
No, but Sarah would help me. You have to rewrite using would. So you have to remove used to. Earlier we were adding used to. Now remove used to. Sarah would help me out with my studies. Fine. My cousins used to visit us every summer. Geek. Shweta?
My cousins would visit every summer.
Very good. My cousins would visit us every summer. Like this, you have to do all the parts. Fine. Next is could and would. Let's do this one. A medieval knight was essential, a mounted soldier whose job was to fight for his lord. Fighting from the back of a horse, it takes a lot of skill and practice. So a lord would give his knights the time and equipment they need to practice. In return, their duties dash include not only fighting. What will... Lavina?
Ma'am, would.
Would not only include fighting in the Lord's army, but guarding his castle, lending him money, and acting as messengers or ambassadors. The knights dash also serve on his council. The knights dash also. Shifa?
Ma'am, could.
Good, bache, this is in their abilities. They can do this. Option. The Lord has considered control over a knight's life, career, and future. The Lord dash decide who the knight. Shweta?
Ma'am, would.
No, the Lord could decide who the knight would marry and could also control over his possessions after his death. The Lord owned the land on which the knight lived and he, last one, who will answer this last one? Tavishi?
Ma'am, he would take it away at any time he and could, give it to someone.
Could. Why the will is used, no possibility. And could is for, you know, he can do this. Please read the usages again, everyone. Would is request, making an offer or a habit. Right? Offer or request. Whereas could is your this ability expressing permission. Fine. So he's not taking the permission. He's saying that he can take it away. He can decide who would marry. This is the permission. Any doubt in this chapter, anyone? Please raise your hands or write it in the chat box now if you have any doubts. Yes, Lakshay.
Ma'am, what would be of E part 7?
7. E part 7. My teachers would say that honesty was the best policy. Just okay. Change this U into would. Any other doubt, anyone? All right, so I'm ending the class. Please send the work after the attendance till 11:30 and then on my personal number. I guess you almost have done it by now. Yes, Shifa?
Ma'am, please keep a competition of this chapter also.
But I'm opening the group. The first one to send it will win. I'm opening the group for this. Because this we have done side by side. So this is not the something that you have to create on your own. Right? Any other thing, anyone?
Ma'am, compliance.
Compliance, I've already WhatsApp everyone on their personal numbers.
Ma'am, but I didn't receive.
No, bacha, I have sent.
And I also didn't receive.
Not today. I'm not talking about today. Compliance was sent on 27th January. Okay, I'll send it today also. Fine? All right. Bye, everyone. Have a nice day. Take good care of yourself.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.